Welcome to This Just In, a weekly news show highlighting the people and events in Newport News Public Schools. After 3 years, funding from the Defense Education Grant is coming to a close for Newport News Public Schools. But with a few summer weeks left, Military Support Counselor Alicia Lytell wanted to make sure the students got the most out of the grant. So, Dozier Middle School hosted a two-week-long summer robotics camp comprised of over 20 military and non-military students who attend middle schools in Newport News. Lytell also enlisted the help of Dozier's Deborah Figgs and Crittenden's tech ed instructor, Dwayne Banks, to help make this summer robotics experience a success. Students spent the first week learning about building and programming the Lego robotics kits. In just a week, the students grasped some very complicated concepts and worked hard to complete their robots for their presentations during the second week. The students also worked on creative writing skills, developing backstories for their robots. During the second week of camp, the students put the finishing touches on their programming skills to allow the robots to carry out various tasks. Near the end of camp, parents were invited to a patriotic-themed catered lunch. Students shared their creative writing with their families, received personalized certificates signifying their completion of the summer camp, and demonstrated their robotic skills by running their robots through a series of obstacles. The parents were amazed at all the students had completed during an 8-day summer camp. The campers also squeezed in time for engaging field trips to broaden the students' career pathways experience and witness some real-world applications of robotics and simulations. They were able to visit the NNPS television studio to receive some hands-on studio training and watch a flying robotic camera that can capture aerial footage. The students also visited the transportation school simulation facility at Fort Eustace. In various rooms, students stepped into some high-tech simulated training, taking the helm of a Navy vessel, flying a V-22 Osprey, and operating all-terrain lifters and rough terrain handlers, all through the safety and fun of simulation. Simulations have become a big part of military and civilian training on expensive vessels and dangerous equipment. During their trips, students asked engaging questions, received hands-on training, and experienced some unique career opportunities related to the robotics field. Kiln Creek Elementary School hosted the 10th annual Newport News Speed Stack Tournament. 21 stackers from 4 schools, Deer Park, Kiln Creek, Nelson Peep, and Our Lady of Mount Carmel, competed in a timed competition, a 4-person team relay, and a single elimination head-to-head tournament challenge. Ben Diongzong from Our Lady of Mount Carmel was the 5th grade time champion, as well as the overall tournament head-to-head champion. This was his 4th consecutive year as champion, and he had the fastest time in the history of the tournament, with 6.80 seconds for the cycle. The world record is 5.59 seconds. Deer Park Elementary captured first place in the 4-person cycle relay, and Deer Park 5th grader Jared Joseph was the overall head-to-head tournament runner-up. Here are more of the results. It's time to hear from an outstanding Newport News Public Schools graduate, the valedictorian from Warwick High School, Olentequit Andres Aguila Soler.
When I attend college, I plan to go to Geotech and study in the College of Engineering. I plan to study mechanical engineering and aerospace engineering. Engineering, I just love it. Since I was little, I've always wanted to build things, fix things, make things better. You know, I always wanted to get my hands dirty, try to make things work. So I always liked airplanes too, and like, you know, especially when you're little, like, you always want to be an astronaut and stuff like that. So building aircraft and spacecraft would be really an ultimate goal for me. It's an interesting time to get started, and hopefully I will get to achieve, you know, putting something out there and be like, yeah, I see that flying object, that I helped build that, or I built it or designed it or something like that. That would be like, for me, that would be like final accomplishment. When I'm not studying, I try to relax mostly, you know, hang out with friends, whatever. It's not like anything planned. It's like, you know, just be with them, see what happens. And I do like to sometimes read, watch TV, or play video games. So for extracurricular activities, of course, I have the Electric Art Club. There's also International Club, National Honor Society, Art Honor Society, French Honor Society, and also do internships at the Peninsula Fine Arts Center and the Virginia Land Museum. So we're volunteer work, and so that keeps me a little bit busy too. And also part of the Usher Ministry and Our Lady of Mount Carmel, and also part of the Knights of Columbus. I definitely attribute my success to her, to my mother, who's like always helped me, and you know, ever since I was little, she gave as much time as she could to making sure that I was motivated to stay in school. She would be the one that was like always at the award ceremony, always pushing me, hey, make sure you do your homework before everything, make sure you have everything that you need to make everything done at school, and whatever you can to make it easier for you to study and succeed. My family, parents, you know, uncles, aunts, grandparents too, they've always supported me, and even though, you know, they're far away and I've only been, you know, it's been a lot while since I've seen it, you know, but still, they've been able to come over here so a couple times, so it's great seeing them, and they've always supported me. They're like one of the main motivations for me to try to do as good as I do, because, you know, they've gone through a lot of trouble. Make sure I get to these opportunities, and it'll be, I think, one of the great motivators, as I told you, is I don't want to disappoint them or make, you know, make that all go to waste. So that's why I try to do good. Hopefully I don't disappoint them.
As part of the Kiln Creek Elementary School's ICARE project, the Magnificent Sensory Garden is a success in both the stimulation of all the senses and in advancing outdoor learning for the entire school. It exhibits plants organized into sections based on the senses of smell, touch, taste, and sight. And each section is labeled with a stone marker, stating the predominant sense associated with those plants. To attract birds, a bird feeder area is also part of the garden. Students are free to experience each of the sections, inspiring their young minds through hands-on sensory examination. Before the end of the school year, a ribbon-cutting ceremony was held to officially open the garden, celebrating the vision of teacher Kenneth DeWitt. Students and staff took part in building the garden, and the school's PTA donated time, plants, and money. Other donors included Yorktown Materials and Peninsula Hardwood Mulch, and trucks and trailers were donated for use by Williams Facility Management. Mr. DeWitt is a landscaper as well as the son of a master gardener, so a garden of this scope and magnitude was a natural choice. You might want to put the first weekend in August on your calendar so you can save money on back-to-school shopping. Virginia's sales tax holiday for school supplies and clothing is August 1st through August 3rd. During this 3-day period, purchases of qualifying school supplies, selling for $20 or less per item, and purchases of qualifying clothing and footwear, selling for $100 or less per item, will be exempt from sales tax. At the same time, a handful of stores are also offering sales and great prices for school supplies. Some of these deals can be found in store or online. You can even like different stores on Facebook to receive more coupons. So take advantage of these deals to help save money on some essential shopping. And don't forget to use any gift cards you have lying around. Thanks for joining us for this week's edition of This Just In. And check out more fun and informative videos at nnpstv.com to see the many things happening in Newport News Public Schools. Thanks for watching.